Now we're going to program it. We're going to plug power in, and the program that was previously in the chip is still running, so it's running that one LED. Now we're going to go to the computer screen, and we're going to add, we have one on pin 4, we have one on pin 10, and now we'll make those go low on pin 4, low on pin 10. Now these are out of order, or they could be out of order, and it doesn't matter because the processing speed is so quick that you will never see this, which one turned on first or which one turned on second. So we'll load this now. There it goes. Now all three LEDs are going together. Now we could change the order that these go by changing a couple of components, and we'll make it go a little faster so it's a little more interesting. And we're gonna take a couple of these down lower, just copy and paste. We'll turn them all in together. And then, let's try that. What's that gonna do? One, they're gonna turn on together, and then turn off at different speeds. So you can set a sequence. And if you change the code accordingly, you could have any LED turn on for any duration, other LEDs changing their cycle, their speeds, their flicker effect. Let's see how fast we can get these guys going. Let's make this a tenth of a second on and off. Okay. So now it's going much faster. We can go even faster than that. Let's go twice as fast. A couple changes of code. Boom. Now it's getting exciting. And like I said before, we can add external chips in the, on this protoboard, which would run hundreds of LEDs if you chose to do that. Okay, so here we are on the software side of the LED display, and we're gonna run through line by line what's been happening here. The first line is telling the processor or the environment that I'm using a basic stamp 2SX chip, which happens to be the blue one. The green one is the basic stamp 2, and you see a little pop-down window appears telling you the name, the label of each model. So in case you can't remember, they show you right there. So you click on that, it pops this in here. And what I think it's doing is it's loading libraries and all the background stuff that the computer chip needs to do to function that you don't need to know about. Just click on that and you're done. This next line here is the basic stamp 2.5 language. These are all just versions. You know, every software goes through versions 1.0, 1.2. That's all that is. Again, it's libraries, it's lookup tables, all the details that you'll never have to know. But just click on that so the computer knows you're using the most modern language and all the functions that they have. Then we go down here. I have zero variables declared. I have zero constants. I have zero notes. Nothing is written up here. It's a very simple program. I've called it main because that's a habit I learned when I started. Most people choose main as their original starting block. It can be any word you want, as long as it's not a keyword that is one of the commands used in the language. Like these down here, it says high. That means you're turning a pin to high voltage or 5 volts. You can't use that as this word here or anywhere else. They're kind of dedicated. Pause is another command word you cannot use. Low, all those things. Go to down here, anything that comes up blue or that's in the manual are reserved words for the language, so we don't run into any complicated, you know, misconceptions there. So we've chosen main here as just the labels to a point in the program where we can jump back to. If you have several of these labels down lower in the program, if it's a more complicated program, you could jump to any point in the program, kind of like a number line. In other programming languages, you have number lines along the side, left side of the program you've written, line 53, 54, 55, and you can go to those lines or reference things. That's just a simple name, anything will do. This first line here, high, is a program reserved word. It's one of the functions that the computer understands. You write high, it's now expecting to see a number, which corresponds to one of the 16 pins on the basic stamp. Any one of these pins can be used to run LEDs. Right below it, we've chosen another one, 4, and now we've done also pin 10 here as well. You could have all 16 go high, and all 16 lights would light up together. Another reserved word, one of the commands, is pause. And like you would imagine, since this is very much like English, It's just going to pause for a certain duration of time, and you choose that number. So this is 50 milliseconds, so a 20th of a second. So here we have low, and the light would turn off on number 6. Then 4 and 10 would still be on because they have not gotten a command to turn off yet. We pause for another 15 milliseconds, then 4 goes low and 10 goes low, and the lights are all turned off. Then it pauses again, then it goes to the next line. The computer runs in a very serial fashion where it goes from one line of code to the next, to the next, to the next, and the branches are occurring if it jumps from one decision to another based on how you program the code. On this last line here, you have a go-to statement, and we've chosen main, so when it hits this line and executes it, it will jump back up to the top where it says main and start all over, and it will do this forever until you turn power off or reset the chip.